In this video, we're going to program a PIC16F88 using PICkit3 and the MPLABX integrated development environment. Now, first of all, I've cobbled up a circuit board, and the details are on the web page on the screen, and there's a link to that web page from the YouTube video page. You can see the layout, you can see the connector that I used, and there's a photo and a layout diagram. All you need is a LED 330 ohm resistor, a 10K resistor, and a passive piezoelectric sounder if you want to follow this tutorial exactly. Now, the PICkit3, I bought this starter kit and then decided not to use the circuit board. In fact, this circuit board is not compatible with the PIC16F88, so you can't use that starter board. However, this is quite a useful thing for learning, and you can download example code, board schematics, user guides. So for self-training, that's ideal. Or you could just buy the programmer on its own without the circuit board. I also downloaded the MPLABX integrated development environment and installed that. And if you go to the downloads page, the Windows installation is the first link. And I downloaded and installed that earlier. And there it is. So we need a new project. It's File, New Project. Microchip Embedded. Standalone Project. Next. It is a PIC16F88. Type it in, select it, click Next. And we're using the PICkit3 programmer. Click Next. We're using the MPASM assembler. Click Next. And I'm going to call it FlashBuzz. And make a folder called FlashBuzz. You need to make your own folder wherever you want to save it. Click Finish. And there's my project. There's one I made earlier. Here's FlashBuzz. And we're lacking a source file. So I'm going to right-click Source Files. Call that FlashBuzz. And that's a program that does nothing. I'm going to delete that code and get my code from the web page. So there's the example code, I'm copying that. Try not to get any extra HTML that's nothing to do with the program. And paste it in. And with a bit of luck, we should be able to build the program. So the blue hammer, build main project, there it goes. Build successful. Now I want to power this from the USB cable. So I need to go into File, Project Properties, PICkit3, Power, and turn on Power Target Circuit from PICkit3. OK that. Now we should be able to hit the Download Program, the Download button, Make and Program Device Main Project. There it goes. This is quite slow the first time, quicker the second time. This window is a warning about voltages, just to make sure you're using 5 volts. OK that. And it says device erased. It's programming it. It's verified it. And that's job done. Success.